Today my healthy breakfast is apple and cinnamon sandwich. It's actually really good. It's got a good cinnamon flavour. It's cooked apple and cream in there. Very healthy.
We've just arrived at Takao Sanguchi Station and today we're going up Mount Takao. It's about an hour by train from Shinjuku. It didn't take that long and it was interesting watching the scenery change as we went along the way. Look, the station building looks amazing and right opposite the station there's a trick art museum. If you didn't see my video from last year, we went to the one in Odaiba and it was so much fun.
Wow, look at the station. It's a Hello Kitty popcorn vending machine and it kicks the popcorn for you. In here.
Not in there,
that's fake popcorn. You can get a cable car or a chairlift up half the mountain and I've just seen a sign saying it's the steepest slope in Japan. So I think we're going to go for one of them. I think the chairlift is more fun, so we're going to get that halfway up and then we're going to get the blue trail because it goes to a suspension bridge. Up to the top and then we're going to go for the orange one on the way down because that one has the best views. And then at the end, if we can, we're going to nip up and see the waterfall and then go home exhausted. Here you can get your tickets from a vending machine. Here's my ticket, 480 yen for a one-way trip on the chairlift. How to get on the chairlift? Stand, sit down on it. There it is. Up there. We got on the chairlift. Don't drop the camera.
We would have been knackered walking up this.
Yes. This is probably a good move. They both got their legs crossed. It says, don't shaking.
It's even higher.
Oh wow, it's really steep over there.
Glad we didn't walk.
We're going over a gap.
Ish.
There still is zero danger really. I wonder how many people's shoes fall off. We're not strapped in, we're just sitting on this thing. We're about to go up the steep bit. It's actually really nice going through the forest.
It looks like quite a short way on the map, right? But it's actually quite a long lift.
Are we going to regret not getting this on the way down, do you think?
No, it'll be fine.
Legs up. This guy's saying, get ready to get off. Like a theme park ride. Keeps going on, there's another steep bit up there. And I think that must be the top at the top of that one.
Something yen well spent.
Yes, good value chairlift. We're getting ready to get off. It says walk on conveyor belt. Uh-oh. I'm scared of getting off. Oh, they made it fine, it looks easy. Get ready. We made it off. Here's the view from the top of the chairlift. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but you can just see the sky tree over there and how built up Tokyo is compared with the rest of the view. Look at this tree clinging on by the roots. We're knackered already and we've only gone this far. It's pretty bad. There's even vending machines up a mountain. Quite a lot of them, what a choice. Phil's been hunting for a particular chocolate milk all trip and every time we walk past the vending machine he's been checking them and he hasn't found it yet. I don't think it exists anymore, but he hasn't given up hope.
Does that ring any bells, Amy?
It's a chocolate milk in a bottle. It Miruku Koko.
I don't remember it being by Asahi, but it could be it.
I'm willing to give it a go. First time that's happened.
Is it going to be the one?
I don't know.
I thought the other one was a more round can. This has got edges to it.
Don't be so fussy. It's not the right bottle.
I thought it had more of a metal top as well, but let's find out.
We've looked at hundreds of vending machines to spare me the one.
The mountain holds the key. You ready?
Brace yourselves.
I think it's the one, you know.
Wow!
I think we've done it.
We found almost taiyaki. They're in the shape of faces instead of fish. So, nearest thing. I really wanted to try taiyaki, so I'm going to have one of these. Here's my almost taiyaki. It's in the shape of a kind of bird, demon, monster face. Looks pretty angry.
That was really good. It was warm and crispy on the outside, and the batter was a bit like a waffle. It wasn't sweet at all, not sugary, and then you've got the sweetness of the red bean paste inside. Really good, but that doesn't mean I won't be trying a taiyaki as well if I see one.
We were just wondering why there's an octopus on this sign. And this tree is called an octopus.
Taco cedar.
Because the roots look like an octopus. The cute octopus tree mascot. I've seen flying squirrels on things several times. I saw a t-shirt with a flying squirrel and some plushy flying squirrels, so I'm really hoping we'll see one because they're so cute. Look how sad this tree is. It's been cut down. All these roots. We keep finding these sticking up from the ground. Health and safety hazard.
Like mudslides or something.
There it is, we come to the rope bridge.
Suspension bridge, I think.
Suspension bridge. Yeah, forest adventure.
Bouncy on the bridge. Look at these vines going up. It's been pretty easy walk up to this point. We've been happily walking along the trail. Around the corner, it starts to get steep.
The stairs. Jump in the mud, Amy.
We're hoping I'm falling then.
I think this tree's gonna fall off.
Do you wanna jump down the edge?
Look, there's a little tree growing inside the tree. We've almost made it to the top. We've made it to the top. We climbed a mountain with cable car assistance.
We've climbed to the top of Mount Takao and there's vending machines up here. It's too cloudy today, but that there is Mount Fuji.
And a Ferris wheel.
Oh yeah. Is that Fuji Q Highland?
I think so, yeah.
It's been a good day out. It was really nice walking through the forest trails, and I like how you can pick your own way up and down the mountain and see different things on the way. And it actually wasn't too difficult to walk up. There were a few steep bits, some uneven steps, but it wasn't too bad. And amazing views from the top. We had some good snacks along the way. I enjoyed that thing that was almost a taiyaki. Oh, and there aren't many foreign tourists here, so I haven't seen this in many guidebooks either, but it's a really good day trip from Tokyo, and it only took less than an hour to get here. Look, I found the suica bar, watermelon ice cream. I've been looking for this everywhere because I heard you could get it in 7-Eleven, but I hadn't seen it anywhere, and here it is at the top of a mountain. It's got crabs on the back. Smells artificial. That's really cold. Watermelon flavour. It's really, really cold. The seeds, when I get to them, are chocolate chips. Yum, yum. It's really cold now. I had that ice cream. We're going back down on the 6th trail, which is supposed to have the best views, and we're going to walk all the way down instead of getting the chairlift. We're going this way, the 6th trail. Look, this way to the flying squirrels. I really hope we see one. We found the stairs, and they carry on as far as you can see. That's the bit we've just done. The rest looks pretty easy, but also long. I think we get near the waterfall. We're following the path of this stream, or walking through the stream, testing how waterproof our shoes are. It was going to be scary because the rocks look really slippery, but it's actually pretty fun going over all the stepping stones, and it's really beautiful with the stream and all the forest around you.
Are they bears?
Warthogs.
Oh, warthogs.
And weasels or ferrets.
And a giant dragonfly.
It looks really 3D. There's a great sense of depth. Look how pretty it is, and it's lovely hearing the sound of the stream and the mini waterfalls. So peaceful.
Just
grabbing
the water.
Oh, oh
no.
You found one.
No, it's me.
I think we're coming up to the waterfall. There's a bit of a drop off and fences to stop us.
I don't know why they put barbed wire up here. Phil said it looks like something out of a game, like you have to snipe something from up here. Wow, look, here's the waterfall through the trees. It's called the Biwa waterfall. I hope you can see how big the scenery is. It's hard to catch it on the camera, but it really is amazing. This is the trail we've been following, the 6th trail. We're just going to go down here to take a closer look at the waterfall and the shrine. Konnichiwa.
Whenever we've gone past other people, everyone says konnichiwa to each other.
Well, that's where we walked down earlier.
Yeah.
Up there. Amazing
sight with the waterfall and the temple or shrine. We found a small shrine or something in the rocks. Just taking a closer look. It looks really mysterious. There's some incense sticks and flowers and lots of cups, and people have left money in a tray. It kind of feels like somewhere we shouldn't be. I really enjoyed that. The way up was fun. It was great to see the views from the top. The chairlift was really good. And the way down just had amazing scenery. The best bit was actually walking through the river, which I thought would be really slippery, but it was actually really fun. And it was just so beautiful walking along by the stream, following it down the mountain in a sort of a ravine the whole time and seeing all the trees and plants around you. So it was a really good day trip. The train here, it said was 360 yen one way when I scanned my Suica card, which seems pretty cheap, so I'll check that for you. And if you are going to come here, make sure you've got waterproof shoes. And not all of the trails are that easy. They do involve a bit of stepping over tree roots and some quite big steps. So I think one of them is a concrete path, so if that's something that you want, do some research and check which one that is before you go. So what we actually did in the end was we got the chairlift, which was 480 yen per person, just one way. We got the chairlift up to the end of that. Then we followed the...
We got the chairlift up, which was 480 yen per person, one way. Then we followed the red trail until we got to the blue trail, which was the one that went past the suspension bridge and up to the top. And then on the way back down, we followed trail 6, which is the green one, which had absolutely stunning scenery, past the waterfall, all the way back to the station. If you're on the easiest route, you can get the cable car or the chairlift up halfway. They're both the same price and go to the pretty much the same place. Then the red route, I think, is the paved one, but do check that. And that's the easiest way up to the top, and you can take that back down again as well. We didn't see any flying squirrels, but we have found this statue by the station. There's one, and he jumps to here.